Students learning about research are expected to learn what ontology, epistemology, and methodology mean. In this video, I'm going to explain and simplify these terms for you. Before we even get into it, you may be asking yourself, why do we ask students to learn this stuff? Students need to learn these terms and how they apply to research so they can look at a study and decide for themselves if it makes sense. Once you understand it, you can critique it and make better decisions about what should be applied to your practice. Ontology is a fancy word for beliefs about reality. Different kinds of research are founded on different beliefs about what we think truth is. Do you think truth even exists? What is true? What we think reality is will shape what we think we can know about reality. That is why it is important to understand ontology when you are learning about and critiquing research. Philosophies about reality can be divided in different ways. When you are just starting to learn about research, it helps to understand the two types of ontology that are essentially opposites, realism and relativism. Once you understand these two types of ontology, you can more easily understand others. In this video, I'm only going to talk about realism and relativism, but in my book, I also talk about critical realism and historical realism as they apply to different approaches to research. First, let's talk about realism. In a nutshell, realists believe that one truth exists. Truth does not change. Realists believe that truth can be discovered using objective measurements. Once you find out what the truth is, you can generalize it to other situations. If you can wrap your head around this view of reality, even if you don't totally agree with it, you will understand why research that is based on this view of reality is designed the way that it is. If this is what the researcher thinks about reality, it will influence every single decision that is made in the study. The opposite view of reality is called relativism. If you look at what I just said about realism, you can probably guess that everything relativists believe is the exact opposite of what realists believe. Using that logic, you know that relativists believe in multiple versions of reality. What is real depends on the meaning you attach to truth. Truth does not exist without meaning. Since reality is created by how we see things, it evolves and changes depending on your experiences. If reality is context-bound, it cannot be generalized. It can only be transferred to other similar contexts. Epistemology is another fancy word that basically means what relationship the researcher has with the research. So, how do we get knowledge? How do we discover new things? Ontological beliefs will dictate epistemological beliefs. Let me say that again in another way. What the researcher believes about the nature of reality will dictate what kind of relationship they think the researcher should have with whatever is being studied. There are two basic beliefs about how we should gather new knowledge. Some researchers believe that research should be done in an objective way, so that the researcher does not influence the data that is gathered. They think that in order to find out what the truth is, the researcher needs to stay as far away from the research as they can, so that they can get an objective measurement. This approach is also known as an ethic approach to research. The word ethic basically means taking an outsider's view of someone else's situation. So, if you use a fishbowl to represent someone's situation that is being researched, the researcher taking an ethic approach would want to look at the fishbowl from the outside, measure it, and make observations without ever touching it. If we go back to look at the two major opposing views of reality, which one do you think leads to this ethic approach to conducting research? That is right! Realism! If you think that truth exists that can be objectively measured, then of course you want to stand back, look at your fishbowl, and try to measure it without disturbing the reality you are studying. The opposite approach to research would be taking an emic approach. An emic approach is used by researchers that believe in a subjective approach to reality. Interacting with people to find out what truth means to them is needed. So these researchers would want to get inside the fishbowl. The potential influence of the researcher on what is being researched is acknowledged, sometimes avoided, or sometimes even embraced. Interaction is seen as a necessary thing to gain an in-depth understanding of what is going on. What ontology do you think leads to this way of approaching research? That is right! Relativism! Remember that relativists believe that the truth is created by meanings and experiences. In order to understand someone's experience and the context that shaped it, you need to dig deep and talk to them. Methodology is another fancy word that means how knowledge is discovered and analyzed in a systematic way. Don't confuse methodology with methods. Yes, they are closely related, but the term methodology refers to philosophies that guide how knowledge should be gathered. The term methods, on the other hand, is specific to data gathering techniques like interviews or surveys. Methodology can be divided based on the ontological and epistemological beliefs that led to them. For the purposes of this video, I want you to take a guess what ontology and epistemology would be linked to an experimental methodology. Let me give you a hint. The purpose of an experiment is to prove that one thing caused another. That is right! Experiments are designed to discover the truth, so they are based on a realist ontology and an ethic epistemology. How can you tell? Well, they are looking for one truth. The methodology behind experimental research is built on the idea that data should be discovered and analyzed in an objective way. Since they are wanting to be objective, they are looking at the topic from the outside, which means they are using an ethic epistemology. The experimental methodology is planned in advance to eliminate the influence of as many contextual factors as possible. Since the only way these researchers believe that truth can be discovered is to remove it from its context. Quantitative researchers want to make generalizations based on their results. An experiment uses a deductive approach to analysis. That means that the study will start with a theory. From that theory, hypotheses will be developed. You normally see these hypotheses explicitly stated at the beginning of the methodology section or just before it. These hypotheses are then tested. Specific data is collected and analyzed to either prove or disprove the original hypothesis. Since the experimental research is designed to be objective, the methods in an experimental study will likely include surveys and other objective measurements like weight, height, blood pressure, and so on. How about another example? What ontological and epistemological beliefs led to a phenomenological study? Let me give you another hint. Phenomenology is designed to explore lived experiences. Often, researchers will do in-depth interviews with people to collect information and understand the context of the experience. I hope you picked up on the key words in that question. Experiences, in-depth, interviews, context. All of these words only make sense if the researcher is using a relativist ontology. The fact that interviews are being done to explore and understand the context of a situation means an emic epistemology is being used. In a phenomenological methodology, research design decisions are made based on complex philosophies about how data should be collected and analyzed. But basically, they start talking to participants to gather as much specific information as they can about a situation. Then they look for patterns or common findings in their data. From those patterns, tentative hypotheses are created. Even though they're not usually labeled as hypotheses in the actual study, because that is a quantitative term. These hypotheses are used to promote more research and eventually general conclusions or theories are developed. When results are presented, they are always linked to the context that was studied. This kind of logic that is most commonly, but not always, associated with qualitative research is called inductive reasoning. Remember, your ontology dictates your epistemology, which dictates your methodology, which dictates your methods. All of this needs to make sense for the question you are asking, since in reality, the question drives everything. If you can understand the basics of realism and relativism, you can use logic to match everything else about research epistemology and methodology to the appropriate paradigm, as long as you know what the terms mean. Let's say you are looking at an article, and you notice they are describing patterns among a large group of people using statistics. If you had to guess, what do you think the ontology and epistemology that led to this approach is? Most times, the article will explicitly tell you if it is quantitative or qualitative, but sometimes it won't. Another way to tell if your methodology is quantitative or qualitative in nature is to look at the use of statistics and the sample size. Typically, quantitative research uses statistics and large sample sizes. Qualitative research, on the other hand, uses smaller sample sizes and thematic analysis. Sometimes it is more complicated than that, so make sure you look beyond the sample and statistics to confirm your guess. Do you think that makes sense based on what we have discussed so far? Please comment below to let me know if you can make sense of the reasoning. I hope you have found this video helpful. For more about the basics of this complex terminology, please read my ebook and let me know if you have any other questions. I also have a few other videos about research philosophy you might want to check out. Sometimes all you need to do to understand something is to hear it explained in a few different ways. That is why I have multiple videos on this topic. If you take a moment to explore my channel, you will see that I have other videos on the same topic that explain things in other ways. If you like my videos, please press the like button and subscribe to be notified when new videos are released. Thank you.